Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are currently on day 6 of their royal tour with baby Archie, and senior aides say the high-stakes trip has to be a success, according to royal experts. Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, and Prince Harry's highly anticipated royal tour of Southern Africa is already more than halfway through, as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex embark on day 6 of 10 today. Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor is also with his parents, and the Duke and Duchess delighted royal watchers with an appearance from their new son as he met Archbishop Desmond Tutu on Wednesday. As Harry finishes his emotional work with anti-landmine and HIV/AIDS campaigners in Angola today, royal experts have spoken about why this tour in particular is so crucial for the royal couple. Royal expert and biographer Katie Nicholl, writing for Vanity Fair this month, said, "The stakes are high for any royal tour this elaborate and long, but Harry and Meghan's trip to Africa carries particular weight, and senior aides acknowledge that the tour has to be a success." Ms. Nicholl continued, "Aides say this will be the first of many trips to Africa for the couple, an opportunity to prove they are not just celebrity royals, but important and vital ambassadors for the royal family." After a summer of scathing headlines about their private jet use, the Sussexes will fly commercial for their first long-haul flight with baby Archie. And the expectations will be high once they get there. Their tour last fall to Australia, New Zealand, Fiji, and Tonga was a rousing success, but also came just months after their wedding and immediately after Meghan had announced her pregnancy. This year, their trip comes after not only the private jet drama, but what was perceived as a family snub when the Sussexes decided not to visit the Queen at Balmoral, even as Meghan flew to New York for the US Open a week later. She added, "The couple has hired an American PR firm to help with damage control, and sources say they hope the upcoming trip will help turn the tide." A source told Ms. Nicholl, "They and their aides know this tour has to be a success, and everything has been planned meticulously so there is no margin for error." Royal commentator Ingrid Seward also spoke to the author, and said that she believes royal baby Archie will be key in cementing the couple's success. M. Seward said, "It will take more than a great tour to turn the tide completely, but if it goes well then it could be the start of a smoother path for them in the press. There's a lot riding on the tour and the feeling is it really has to go well for the couple." Archie is set to emulate his cousin Prince George, who went on his first royal tour with Kate Middleton and Prince William at less than a year old. The little prince was so popular that he was dubbed the Republican Slayer by the Australian media. M. Seward continued, "People will want to see baby Archie, who could be the key player in this. I think if they show us a glimpse of Archie it could turn things around for the Sussexes." She also gave her opinion, "It's a step in the right direction. When you look at all the bad press they've had, it's clear that they've got to claw back some of the goodwill that made them so popular around the royal wedding and which has diminished ever since." Unlike Kate and William's highly photographed arrival with Prince George in Australia, and Meghan and Harry's own prominent arrival in Sydney last year, this time the Duke and Duchess of Sussex made a very low-key royal arrival in South Africa. Ms. Nicholl explained, "There won't be a traditional welcome at the airport when the family and their 16-strong entourage arrive, because the South African president is not there to greet the couple." As Harry will to travel on to Malawi later today, Ms. Nicholl also explained what Meghan and Archie's schedule is set to look like. She wrote, "Meghan will stay behind with Archie and continue a busy schedule of her own, though many of her meetings will be private so as not to detract from Harry's work." Meghan Markle, Duchess of Sussex, has told a group of women she has no intention of sacrificing her heart's desires as she continues to enjoy royal life. The Daily Mirror reports the remarks were made as she joined the Woodstock Exchange's Ladies Who Launch meeting on her trip to South Africa. However, some have commented the royals' more relaxed attitudes to etiquette have caused confusion. Jackie Boking of BoCab Civic and Ratepayers Association explained, "I have no idea how to speak to them. We haven't received any official brief on etiquette. I think that's because the Sussexes want to keep it informal." They concluded, "I don't even know how to greet them." Massey Modise, one of the group, discussed some of the talk with the Woodstock Exchange. She explained, "She talked about being a mother and having duties as a duchess and fulfilling what her heart desires. and that it can't just fade away now that you're a duchess. That you have to be true to who you are. Ms. Motsai says Meghan encouraged the group to push forward in their ambitions. She said, she wasn't referring to being a royal, but life in general when you have challenges. She radiates grace and she is taking this task that she has with such grace. Meghan spoke to Laura Rosemarin of Gape Innovation and Technology about raising son Archie Harris in Mountbatten, Windsor. Meghan said, "We're only 5 months in right now. Being a working mom and traveling as well with a baby, my goodness, it's a lot, but it's also exciting. There are days when it's a lot to juggle, but then you meet someone, have an impact on them, and it's so rewarding." Meghan and Archie in South Africa, whilst Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex, visits Angola, Malawi, and Botswana. This trip is the first time Archie has traveled abroad. Archie was born on May 6 this year. He was born in the same hospital that saw the births of Princess Beatrice and Princess Eugenie. Beatrice made headlines after announcing her engagement to Eduardo Mapley Motsi. Eugenie was married last year to Jack Brooksbank. Speculation has been spreading in recent weeks on whether or not Eugenie will give birth at some point in 2020. Beatrice and Eugenie are cousins to Harry.